The Holy Tales. Hello, children. My name is Holy. I live here in this wonderful library. Three little bookworms who also live here come to me every day to listen to some really lovely stories from the Bible. I wonder where they are today.
Hi, Holy! Sorry we are late. It's Gumbo's fault. Like always, he got lost. It's such a big library.
Well, you are here now, so let us start with today's story. Today's story is about the Valley of Dry Bones.
Wow, that sounds scary.
Well, it's not. It's actually quite interesting. Once upon a time, there was an Israelite priest in God's temple in Jerusalem called Ezekiel. Ezekiel lived with his people who had been taken captive by the Babylonians. He had a vision of God. Ezekiel could feel the power of the Lord, and he also felt that God was with him. The Lord one day took him to a valley and showed him around. The valley had dry bones everywhere, scattered on the ground. The Lord spoke to Ezekiel and said,
Ezekiel, can these bones come back to life?
Ezekiel replied,
Great God, only you can answer that.
So the Lord told him to speak to these bones the word of the Lord. Ezekiel did as he was told. He spoke the words of God, and while speaking, he heard the noise of the bones joining together. They became many bodies, but the bodies were not breathing. God then asked Ezekiel to speak to the wind. He spoke to the wind, and the wind started to blow from everywhere, giving life to these bodies. All the bodies came to life and stood up as a large crowd. God then explained to Ezekiel,
The people of Israel think that they are dried like these bones because they are in other lands. They say that they can never come back. But I will bring them back to their own land. This is my promise, and this will happen.
This is how the Lord breathed life into these dry bones.
Wow! That was such an amazing story. We all loved it. So, what is today's question?
Today's question is, in which temple was Ezekiel a priest?
He was a priest in the temple of Jerusalem.
Very good, Freckles.
Bye, Holy. Thanks for the story.
Goodbye, children.